All right, welcome back, everybody. Aesop, Grimm here. This is a rare back-to-back-to-back recording for me, but it's the continuation of our Crusader Kings 3 Chronicle, where we're trying to reclaim Italia. Currently, we are at war with the King of Aquitaine, who is trying to take back this county right here. And really, I mean, he should have it, but we're fighting him for the general principle. It's actually us. It's part of the Kingdom of Sicily. She is our vassal over. She has territory over here, and then I think she inherited this. So we're trying to protect it, but more because I just want, you know, the Crusader Blade allows me to fight the battles in Bannerlord, and that's fun. And we had a mod change, and I kind of wanted to show that off a little bit. Not that I've really been able to show anything that looks exceptionally different, and the results have been similar to what we've seen during the rest of this playthrough. We just flat haven't run in it. If we came down here, we would see some big differences, I think. But we're currently sieging Tortoli, and that's going to take 19 months. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually pause you for the first time. I'm going to pause you during a war because we're just sitting here waiting. Now, if we get attacked, then I'll bring you back again. If another significant event happens, I'll bring you back. But for right now, we're just sitting here waiting to siege this thing down, and it's 19 months. So I will see you guys in a little bit. All right, guys, welcome back. Bringing you back briefly, I've completed that siege. And I saw a Byzantine Empire show up over here, so he's probably going after the war goal. Yeah, see, here he is. And this war might be wrapping up here pretty soon. We're at a plus 33%. I'm going to go ahead and roll down to Cagliari. And this might be a three-year siege. Because I know I've built Cagliari up. We're counter-sieging it now. 2 years left. Okay. So, same story here. I'm going to put you on pause. In the meantime, I'm letting you know that I'm running sway schemes on my dukes to try and get them up as high as possible in opinion. We need to assign a new spy master. And while I'm at it, I need to fill court positions because our spy master died of old age. And we have a few positions that similar things happened. I don't think I have anybody. Nope. Bodyguard? No, I guess not. Or not for an additional bodyguard. I do have bodyguards already, but I have as many as are available currently. Okay, so yeah, I'll see you in a little bit. We got a two-year siege left here. We're at plus 32%, and our liege is on the continent and is probably going to be doing the things necessary to close this war out as we take back Cagliari. See you in a little bit. Okay, welcome back, everybody. Two things here. One, we plummeted in our war score to plus 6%. So something happened over here that was in Aquitaine's favor, something pretty big. And it looks like maybe my liege's army was defeated. We, on the other hand, have taken Cagliari back. And at the same time, we lost a county over here, although I can't seem to find where. Maybe it was Lucca. I think we lost Lucca. It was sieged down. So we're only at plus 6%. But my liege signed with a white peace with the other war that he was fighting. So now he can dedicate everything to fighting the battle over here. What we're going to do is we're going to go back and take Lucca. Then we're going to come down here to Salerno and see if I can raise any more of my troops. And I'm probably going to order mercenaries. And we're going to roll over here and try and get this war goal of Marsan. So let's play at speed 4. I'll keep you around for this one because I have a plan that's actually happening. We're not just sitting around sieging someplace down. We got 7,000 troops. Oh, that's odd. I can't counter siege this. I'm not in the right spot. There we go. Oh, Arbore is now under siege, so he's got 6,000 troops. Yeah. Okay. So it's a little bit of a ping pong effect happening right now. I probably just need to go for the jugular. Oh, 14,000 strong. I think we're seeing the beginning of the end here. Yeah, that's why I told you that was a significant event when our liege signed a white peace. That meant that he could focus everything on this war right here. And Aquitaine is now facing the full force of the Byzantine Empire. It's going to be too much for him. Unless they got some allies tucked away somewhere. Because they're out of gold, I believe. Reduction of 8 stress. We're chillaxing. Irish War. Okay, we accept. And basically, we'll be there when we can. But you're going to have to understand that you called me to war whenever I was already at war. So I have obligations I have to fulfill first. You know, hold the line, hombre. Oh, plus 100%. Okay, so we're just going to simply take our group of 7,000 and start heading. Who are you fighting? Right here. That's a long trip. And we got victory. That is a really long trip. Of course, he's made it for us a couple of times. Low county control, artifacts with, let's take care of this stuff here. Even if I'm not using it, I kind of try to keep everything in good order. Might as well ask for gold. We'll get 1,500. I don't really want to send anybody to university. Ah, you need a guardian. Our priest is 26 and learning. Prisoners can be ransomed for 100 gold. 100 gold. 2 dukes and a mayor. The mayor gets us 30 gold. Excellent. stewardship perk, and that's going to be popular figurehead. Popular opinion plus 50. I love that one. Ah. You, who are perpetually scarred, you are severely injured. She just always seems to be hurt. It's been like that since she was a little girl. So you're 16. You're my daughter? Yeah. I have to check. There's a 26-year-old, Duchy of Verona. 7,000 people, yeah. Oh, what about the Prince of Wallachia? 5,000. Well, closer to 6,000. Savona Treviso. Cisalpine. I mean, the likelihood of us knowing both of these are, it's pretty good. Let's go with this one. And send that proposal. Okay. Alliance formed with Duke Falco II, the Wicked of Verona. Okay, we've landed. That's not much of a fight. So we'll slaughter them and siege down their castle. Well, we're going to start a private garden and we gain herbalist. What does herbalist do for us? Disease resistance, medium boost, learning plus 2, intrigue plus 2. That's nice. That's a good trait. Was there a chance that we gained it, or was it guaranteed? I'll have to check. Our brother got caught doing stuff that he ain't supposed to be doing. Oh, we took the High Chieftain's son and heir hostage. Wow, that's a significant development. Oh, look at this. Available dynasty legacy. I was working on law. Delegated authority. Powerful vassal opinion plus 5. Counselor tax contribution and levy contribution plus 10%. That's what we'll take. Delegated authority unlocked. Okay. We had a victory. What else needs to be hit? Because I don't actually see anything. Let's open this up. Do you have allies? You don't have any allies. That actually should have ended the war. Maybe we have to siege these areas down, which they are in the process of doing. I think we can begin the process of heading home. Our work here is done, I believe. I think we're going to see this ratchet up pretty quickly. Although seeing it ratchet down is kind of alarming. Wait a minute. Okay, no, it is sieged down. I did my job. Maybe we need to hit this place. Strike a deal with the Chief Mason. How about we let Princess Theodosius handle this? C3. 7 months left on that on pause. Sounds very good. You see, we have two green arrows. Sometimes that gets up to like five, I think. And I don't know exactly what that means. I'm thinking that there's some sort of bonus being applied. Oh, he's got an 8,000 strong army. We're going to have a fight with some Norsemen. This could be interesting. If she wants to live in isolation, she can do so somewhere else. What is this about? Marciana. My cupbearer. Scaling a pillar in the palace yard in the morning and remaining there all day in quiet contemplation. She refuses food and drink and says relatively little when questioned. Ascetic practices like these aren't unheard of. But it's bothering some of your court, and they're asking me to do something about it. Yeah, this was a major movement in the Middle Ages, the asceticism movement. Marciana's banished from the realm? No, I'm not going to imitate. I wouldn't banish her for that, what? Alright, pause. Alright, now. We have superior quality in our troops. High quality versus decent quality. They've got more men, so it's pretty evenly balanced, but it's actually in our favor. We should still win this. And we might see our new mod at work here, because this is a different kind of troop tree that we'll be seeing. This is the Norseman troop tree. Okay, so I think I'm going to set up in the middle here. And then I'm going to make a group of about 10% because the number situation. They're going to come out here. Hitting the wrong buttons. There we go. Like that. Okay. And I'm not quite set up the way I want to be. Yeah, I kind of wish that I had a little bit more there just to cover the full width, but I think we're set now. They're coming to me.
Infants, shields up! Footmen, arms, shields! Bowmen, arms length apart! Hold!
Let's see here. My footman back here got into a weird kind of...
Move! Footman! Forward!
A weird angle, I think. That's better. Now I just need them to move up closer. Okay, so they have cav to the right. and probably to the left as well, although I don't see a symbol for it. But I, because of how this is set up, I didn't get everything perfectly centered. My right flank for my archers is at a little bit more risk. So I'm going to... Are they close? Not close enough yet. I like to wait for 150. I'm going to cover my right flank with my cav. Okay, so here we go. Now, once I tell my bowmen to go ahead and go weapons free, that's typically whenever I go on my cav charge. And I leave my infantry in the shield wall. Oh yeah, we got different looking troops. Get away from that. Oh, they're pretty heavily armored. I'm gonna let my cav go. I think I'm getting beat. Okay, that guy goes down. That's really all I'm interested in. Now, their foot soldiers are probably going to be a nightmare. Although they do seem to be rowdy. They have axes, so they're able to beat down my shields. I think we held. It looks to me like we held, but... That's cool. It's not a long battle. It's a slugfest. In boxing, the term we might use would be an elevator fight. Each side is getting floored, and it's who's going to be the last one to be able to get back up. Because you can see, if you were watching that bar, they were in... It was in their favor for a while, and they were, our bar was shrinking, so they were hitting us really hard, but we were able to hold out through our defensive capabilities, our toughness, and it then kind of switched into our favor. That was cool. That was cool. And then it snowballed from there. Yeah, I thought that was really neat. Let's survey. Let's look at the dead. You can see the cost of victory here. It doesn't look like any of my infantry troops back here died. I don't see any dead lying on the ground from them. It was all archers. So that means they did their job. They made the enemy pay a price. I think. Are these just all my guys? Are there no dead of theirs? Some of this is going to be my settings where the corpses disappear. Look, there's a dead horse. That blue and red would be theirs. I think these are all their troops. Boy, that was a heavy hitting slugfest, though. Which is what you would expect if you were in Bannerlord having Empire versus Sturgians. Man, that's cool. How did we do? We had 14 kills, so not bad. I usually consider 15 to 20 to be a good fight. And if you're up in the 20 plus, you did real good. Well, you know, for me, I shouldn't apply that to anybody else. That's where I'm at when it comes to Bannerlord. Unpause. Let that complete. 7,230 losses to our 3,500. And we captured somebody. We're at 100% now. Perfect. Perfect. We can go back home. All right. We needed to do that because Ireland answered the call to arms against the Pope twice. And this is like the most Catholic nation in Europe. Well, this exists. But Ireland has been at the top, you know, in the top three for hundreds of years. So for them to come in and help us in two fights, two wars against the Pope, I kind of wanted to return the favor. Let's go all the way to speed 5. Oh no. I am heading for my chambers to enjoy some blessed sleep when I hear a faint rustle from a window. Just the wind, I think, until the wind starts to speak. Marciana, open up, my sunshine. It is I, Methodius. I push the shutters open, and lo and behold, a man has climbed up to Marciana's window. It is Duke Methodius of Ephesus. Dead comet. She's of our dynasty. Oh man, not Tiberius. This is who we play as when we're doing the Bannerlord fights. So as this guy was fighting his war, putting his life on the line for king and country up here, his wife is back home seeing somebody else. All right, so we let everybody know about that. That's shameful. That's shameful. We should make her do some kind of walk of shame. Now that's something you don't see every day. Oh, how the days drag on, the same old motions repeated over and over again. Come to the grand hall, my liege. You must see this, the servant suddenly exclaims. As I arrive, I see my jester, Girolamo, in the middle of the room, masterfully juggling a feather. My ceremonial sword, a bottle of invigorating herbal infusions, a rooster, and an apple. All the servants are staring in awe, and so am I. Yeah, take the stress loss. Well, oh well, off to the dungeon with him. Yeah, because he was messing with the ceremonial sword. Now that's impressive, though. The guy with his victory dance. Aha, I've done it. Wherever I go, my beneficiary Petronella is sure to follow. The look in her eyes, the words on her lips, I know exactly what she is after. No, I tire of these games. Leave me alone, all of you. When you're trying to build a family dynasty, you need to be kind of family-centric, you know? Infidelity doesn't help with that. Disband army. All right. Now we're at the very end of this episode, but what we can do now is, oh, you know what? I'm a knucklehead. I should have had us fabricating on Orvieto this entire time. All right, but Orbitello, I actually want to create a scum save here. He's got a 71 opinion of me. This is my brother. I'm really sorry. but I'm gonna need that title from you. He will accept it, and since I have a claim on it, there's no fighting back. So keep Theodosius in mind. Maybe we will give him the county of Urbino. Revoke that title. All right. Now, that presently brings me to my limit in my domain. And we still need Orvieto, and that's where Urbino comes in. Once I'm able to get this, I will give this away, probably to Theodosius. Okay. Before we end it, let's get construction going. We will upgrade to manor houses, windmills. Windmills make most of the labor, take most of the labor out of grinding flour, massively increasing efficiency. Okay, and we will bump up to mustering halls. Dedicated mustering halls placed in every village makes it much easier to press levies into service. Yeah, upgrade. Okay. Cagliari, I believe, can move to class 6 on walls and towers. Outer Baileys, I've read that before, and we will run with that. I don't think Arezzo's mine. Oh, no, I'm wrong. It was someplace else. It's in the Tuscany. Let's see. Move from small hill fort to simple earthworks. Ditches, stockades, guardhouses, external walls, large hill fort. It is a castle holding. Do we have the wrong thing here? No. Okay. Well, hill forts it is. The county of Lucca will go to second curtain wall. The addition of a second curtain wall makes for an unsurpassed defensive position. If an enemy army manages to break through the first wall, they will be greeted by yet another, enough to demoralize any assailant. Florence can upgrade to level 2 on pastures. That will be homesteads. Homesteads house peasant farmers who grow grain and keep animals for their own use. Siena can move to level 3 here. Meadows. Meadows are used both for grazing and to produce hay for tougher times. Orbitello is currently constructing farmsteads. And what kind of land are you on? You're on plains, okay. I think this should be converted to pastoral lands. Maybe not. No, I'll stick with hunter stables. Okay, so we will save this game. I think that's going to be it for tonight. Maybe it just simply for right now. But I'm certainly taking a break. That's 3 back-to-back-to-back episodes, and it was fun. I enjoyed it. But again, I'm Aesop Grimm. Thank you for coming by the channel. I hope you like what you saw. I hope all is well in your neck of the woods. And I will see you in the next episode, where this story continues.